Hello student, let us start chapter 6. Your chapter is application of derivative and your first topic is rate of change of quantities. Now you see, to start this function, this topic, let us consider a function. Say you consider a function that y is equal to fx be a function of x. Now you see, if you give a small increment in x, say delta x in x, then the corresponding change in y will be delta y. Okay, because you say in this case x is independent variable and y is your dependent variable. So for a small increment, delta x in x, the corresponding change, that is your increment. Increments, I hope you understand, increment means just a change. This may be positive, this may be negative. Okay. So here you see, for a small increment in delta x in x, the corresponding change in y be delta y. Play small delta y or by capital delta y. Then you see, then delta y by delta x. This represent what? The unit change. This represent the unit change. This represent as unit change in y due to the small change in x. And now you see, in the limiting case, that means when you consider the limiting case, and then if you consider, suppose this one, in limiting case, say delta x tends to 0, approaches to 0, then delta y by delta x is symbolically denoted by what? Dy dx. And what does it represent? This represents the instantaneous change in y, okay, with respect to x. Or we can say like this, rate of change of y with respect to. Now, in this chapter, we will discuss about this thing. That means, what is the change in y? Rate of change in y with respect to the change in x. Okay. So, to start this chapter, you have to know a few results which we have got earlier. Different results of area, surface area, volume, perimeter, all these formulas we have to know first. So, let me give you some preliminary result here before going to the main topic. Before going to the exercise, let me give you some preliminary concept of these order formulas related to different diagrams, geometrical figure. Suppose we are considering first a rectangle. If I consider a rectangle, let us consider x be the length and say y be the breadth. Then you see the area, say it is symbolically represented by say A, then area of the rectangle will be given by, hope you remember this, rectangle will be given by xy and the unit is square units. And how the perimeter is represented by? And perimeter, say you represent it by P. Perimeter of the rectangle is 2 into x plus y and it is unit. Unit means if the measurement of x and y is in, say, centimeter, the perimeter is in centimeter. If it is in meter, then the result will be in meter, like this. After that, after the rectangle, let me give you the next result for square. Up to surface area and volume you have to know. Okay, so if I consider a square, you know that all the length of a square are equal. So if I consider, let x be the length or the x be the length of a side. Of a side. Then what is your area? Let me represent area by A. As I mentioned here. So area is given by what? X square, and the unit is square unit. And perimeter, let me represent it by P. Perimeter is given by what? The length of all the boundary lines. That is equal to what? 4x. And it is unit. 4x. Now you see, for a circle. You know, for a circle, let R be the radius. Let us consider R be the radius. Then its area is given by pi r square, square units. And the circumference, in case of circle, we represent it as circumference. Circumference C is given by twice pi r, and the unit will have. Circumference, that is the perimeter of the circle, the length of the circle. Length of the line of the circle, that is the perimeter or the circumference, is your twice pi r. Right? After this, let me go to some results for area and surface area and the volume. Okay, so first let us consider the next one. Let me consider your, just a minute. Let me consider a cuboid. Cuboid. I hope you remember, cuboid is sometimes also called rectangular parallelepiped. Okay, this is the diagram you see. This is a cuboid. Say L be the length and B be the breadth and H be the height. So let us consider, let length is L. L units. Breadth is B units. And the height is X units. If I consider length, breadth and height as L, B and H, then you can write down what is the, or you know now, what is the volume of the cuboid. So how the volume is given by? Volume. Let me represent it by V. Volume is given by L, B, H, and this is cubic unit. And its total surface area. Total surface area, that means, what do you mean by total surface area? The area of all the faces, six faces. It's given by two times of LB plus LH plus BH. And this is area, so square units. And lateral surface area. Lateral surface area. This is given by the area of the walls. And that is given by 2 times of LH plus BH units, square units. And here we can take common H and we can write the formula like this also. Okay? Hope you remember all these results. After that, let us consider a cube. You see, the next is let us consider a cube. In case of a cube, what we have? All the sides are of same length. So the next is number 5, that is cube. Okay, so let us consider L. Let L be the length of the side. Then what will be your volume? Volume is given by, I just wrap these things. The volume will be given by all this, in case of a cuboid, it is LBH. So all L, B and H are equal in case of a cube. So it will become L. Cubic units. And the total surface area, you see cube has six faces and area of one face is L square. So six faces will be equal to what? 6L square square units. And a cube has four walls, so the lateral surface area will be equal to 4L square square units. Right? After this, let us go to the next figure, that is, say, a rectangular, right circular cylinder. So in case of a right circular cylinder means this one. The axis is perpendicular. This is a right circular cylinder. So here let us consider like R beta radius and H beta height. R beta radius of the base and H beta height. In that case, you see, we can write down that R beta radius of the base and H beta height. Right? Then its volume is given by pi R square H unit is cubic units. Total surface area is given by, you see, the total surface area is the combination of the curved surface area at the top and the bottom. So that is given by 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square, which can be written as 2 pi r, you can take common, you will have your r plus h, and the unit is square units. And the curved surface area. You can write down in short CSA. That is equal to what? Twice pi RH unit is square units. Right? Now, let us consider the next figure, a right circular cone. You see, in case of a right circular cone, say this is your right circular diagram of a right circular cone. Your radius of the base is R. Let H be the height. And let L be the slant height. Now this is the slant height, and let H be the height. So here R be the radius of the base, H be the height, and L be the slant height. Then you see what is the volume. The volume is 1/3 of pi r square h. And the total surface area. Total surface area will be given by. The total surface area is given by pi r l plus the area of the base, which is a circle. So it will be pi r square and unit square unit. Taking common pi r, you can write down the formula again, which can be written as pi r taking common l plus r. And what is your curved surface area? This is pi r l. And you see here we have to know one more result, that is for slant height. You see, in the diagram, if I consider this as H, because height of the cone is H, and that is L. So, since this is a right circular, right angle triangle, so L can be written as H square plus R square. And then L will be given by root over H square plus R square. You see, you try to remember all these formulas, because here in the next one more chapter we will have. Here it will be applied in this chapter. One more chapter will have maxima and minima. There also all these formulas will be applied. So try to remember all the formulas. After this, let us go to the next is your, sphere. So say, R with a radius. Only the radius will be required. The volume will be given by. You see, the volume is given by 4 by 3 pi r cube. Unit is cubic units. Then the total surface area and the curved surface area is same. Because there is only one surface. So surface area, you can write down, that is the total surface area. Is what? 4 pi r square. That is square units. Right? So you try to remember all these formulas. This will be applied in this chapter. So next time I'll start our first exercise, exercise 6.1. Thank you.